get experience and the football. So, you know, we started off, in the second half. Got great in there, good spark on the game. I went on and just left him in there. It was a valuable experience for him, I thought, because it was, the game was not out of hand when he got in. But as it got that way, you know, I think he showed some things that, yeah, it's a great experience.
Have you talked to Phil since then?
During the game, that's it. Yeah. So we just talked to the team, and you know, I haven't had a one-on-one with anybody since then. Really, you know, we just talked to the whole team after the game, just about, you know, where we are, what the expectations are, and that's not going to change. And you know, really, right now, you can't go backwards. And you know, that was basically my message to the team. I said, hey, look, how we're going to approach this week. Are you gonna let this define you, or are we gonna keep pushing forward? And that's the choice you have. That's the choice that this whole team has. And that's when, you know, coaches, we gotta lead, and our leaders gotta lead too during the week. And you know, we gotta keep moving on, because we still got a lot of things out there in front of us. A lot of good stuff that's out there in front of us if we approach this thing the right way.
Do you know right now
when
you're starting quarterbacks?
Yeah, it's not a quarterback controversy. I mean, it's where we are right now. So we want to get Grant in there. That was a plan. And last week I told you guys that he wouldn't be a redshirt. So, you know, it was obvious that he was going to play some more the rest of the year. You know, he's going to play a lot tonight.
So does that mean
Bill's going to start
again?
Yeah, there's no quarterback controversy right now. So yeah, we're moving on from this. And that chart's still the same.
What did the USC defense do to Tate and your own line that made it so difficult?
Well, you know, there were blitzes that obviously that we didn't pick up. But then again, even during that time, you know, they whipped us in front. We couldn't run it. And then when they didn't blitz, you know, we still weren't. Whether it was Khalil, you know, who was running for his life early in the game, and then, you know, Grant got hit a bunch of times, you know, just about every series. So some, you know, because he's not as mobile, but we got whipped up front.
What is supposed to happen on those plays that's maybe not happening?
Well, it starts with, it's just like running ball too, you know, that we got to be better up front. We got to the perimeter a couple times early in the game. We weren't consistent in the run game, which put more pressure on us to be able to throw the ball. And they pressured us, you know, with edge blitzes, safety blitzes, brought a free safety blitz a couple times. It was just flat bust and protection. Where we just turned a guy loose off the edge. Wide squeezes, and the guy came off the edge and untouched. So, you know, later on in the game, Grant hit running backs a couple times hot because they didn't cover him and make yards. You know, you gotta get the ball out of your hands sometimes. You can bring more than you have to protect. But you also gotta block him when you're supposed to block him. So it was a combination of a lot of those things, right? So there are answers that we got to, but it was too late. There are answers that should have been had by protection that were just blown assignments. So, you know, we gotta be better now.
Last week, early in the game, there were turnovers.
Yes.
Self-inflicted wounds.
Exactly.
And what's going through your mind? Pretty much the exact same.
Exactly. Yeah. You got. You know, we muffed the punt, right? Give them a short field. What do you get? 10 points off of that. Back. You know, gets the crowd into it on the road. It's frustrating. You know, it's frustrating. Wiley's trying to get another yard. You know, playing hard. You guys want to go. So we got 2 turnovers early in the game that really, you know, our defense, you know, for where they were with the short fields, you know, for the first half, really with those turnovers, I thought they were pretty effective. Held them a field goal once, stopped them on short yardage, and gave us a chance. But you know, we gave them short fields with early in the game and really the first half with turnovers, and we couldn't move the ball offensively, effectively. You know, we get to a certain point and stall out, or they get, we have negative yardage plays with sacks, force us out of the pocket, or, you know, whatever. So it's a combination of those things that gave them short fields and gave us long fields.
Was it a harder decision at all to take Khalil out, given that he's coming back home?
I mean, in this game, you know, they're just games. It's, you know, that's not what that's all about. You know, it's about him, but it's about the team too, and where we were at that time and at that moment in the game. It was time to, you know, try to get us apart like anything else.
How would you assess the play of Slovis in the USC run game?
I talked to him after the game. You know, he was effective, right? They were able to run it. He threw some good balls, accurate. I thought he did a nice job of managing things. He's got a bright future.
Did anything surprise you with him, or was it kind of what you expected?
I don't know if it's surprising. You know, he's a good player, and has been. They've got some talented people around it, too, that can make plays for him. Post was a good ball. He just got out, jumped down on the post route. He threw some accurate balls. He threw some real accurate balls. And they moved around a little bit. We got to him a couple of times, didn't really rattle him. So he's got a bright future.
How much harder is it on the defense when you're not really able to flip the field in a major way?
So that's what I was talking about. You know, we add, we're not able to flip the field.